Elkosites represent this Jewish Christian tradition. In particular, we can point to the Ebionites, a group that was established around the year 70, about the time of the destruction of the temple. And then they fled from the vicinity of Jerusalem and spread to what is today Jordan, Syria, Turkey, and Egypt. Of note, the Ebionites continued as a viable movement within greater Christianity throughout the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th centuries CE. Likewise, the Nazarenes were known to have existed in greater Syria at least as late as the 4th century CE. Both groups, Jewish Christian. While reviewing the preceding historical record, one finds evidence of a trajectory within early Christianity that can be traced back to the biblical books of Matthew and Acts and the Jerusalem church, and that continued to exist well into at least the 4th century CE, and that continued to restrict active preaching to the children of Israel. Of note, the groups represented by this longitudinal trajectory also firmly rejected the Pauline abrogation of the so-called Mosaic laws governing dietary restrictions, etc. In this way, these groups were also more or less consistent with Islam. Any student of comparative religion knows that there are major similarities in the understanding of Jesus and Mary by Islam and early Christianity. However, when we consider the crucifixion event, we come to a fundamental discrepancy between Islam and modern Christianity. The Quran declares that Jesus was not crucified, even though his persecutors thought that they had crucified him. That they said and boast, "We killed Christ Jesus, the Son of Mary, the Messenger of God." But they killed him not, nor crucified him. But so it was made to appear to them. And those who differ therein are full of doubts, with no certain knowledge, but only conjecture to follow. For of a surety they killed him not. No, God raised him up unto himself. And God is exalted in power, wise. Quran chapter 4, verses 157 to 158. The Quran says that Jesus was not crucified, a position in marked conflict with contemporary Christianity. Instead, God raised Jesus up unto himself, a statement having parallels with the ascension of Jesus as portrayed in the biblical Gospels of Mark and Luke. Now, for most contemporary Christians, indeed for most inhabitants of the Western world, it is almost unthinkable that anyone could seriously maintain that Jesus was not crucified. Such critics of Islam might even maintain that the alleged resurrection of Jesus is a matter of personal religious belief, but the crucifixion of Jesus is a matter of an unblemished historical record. However, as we shall soon see, the actual historical record is otherwise than we might expect. Outside of the New Testament and other early Jewish and Christian scriptural writings, there are only two references to Jesus being crucified in the entire historical record of the first and early second centuries. The first was made by Josephus ben Matthias, a first century Jewish historian. The second by Tacitus, a first and second century Roman. Neither writer was present at the crucifixion event. For that matter, most biblical scholars maintain that none of the New Testament authors who wrote about the crucifixion event were present at it. Nonetheless, the skeptic of the Islamic position that Jesus was not crucified will rightly insist that any serious attempt to refute the crucifixion of Jesus must marshal an impressive array of documentation that there was serious controversy about whether or not Jesus was crucified. Where is that documentation? They may well ask. The answer is that it is to be found within the writings of early Christianity itself. In short, the discrepancy about the crucifixion event between Islam and contemporary Christianity obscures the fact that many branches of early Christianity maintain quite adamantly that it was not Jesus Christ who was crucified. This can be verified by examining the writings of the so-called apostolic fathers of early Christianity, the so-called New Testament Apocrypha, and yes, even the New Testament itself. The writings of the apostolic fathers frequently noted that there were Christian groups that rejected the proposition that Jesus had been crucified. Such references can be found in the writings of Ignatius, Polycarp, Justin, Irenaeus, Tertullian, and Hippolytus. Together, these apostolic fathers represent a veritable who's who of early Christianity. As a specific example, we can turn to the Trallians, a book authored by Ignatius, the Bishop of Antioch, who died around the year 110. In referring to the crucifixion event, Ignatius wrote that there were Christians of his day who denied that Jesus was crucified in reality, but was crucified only in appearance or in illusion. Now, in considering this statement from Ignatius, one has to first of all acknowledge the fact that Ignatius couldn't be attacking a belief that wasn't already present. So we have documentation that there were Christians who did not believe that Jesus was crucified, at least as early as the year 110. But also the very fact that Ignatius bothered to attack these groups suggests that that belief structure, that it was not Jesus who was crucified, was fairly widespread by at least 110. Well, the fact that many branches of early Christianity maintained that it was not Jesus who was crucified can also be readily verified by considering the so-called New Testament Apocrypha. For example, the Apocalypse of Peter, 81 through 82, maintained that Jesus was crucified only in appearance, not in reality, with the one who was crucified being a substitute or simulacrum of Jesus. Likewise, the second treatise of the great Seth, 55 through 56, stated that it was not Jesus who was crucified, but Simon, presumably Simon of Cyrene, who is identified in the biblical Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke as having been the person who carried Christ's cross for him. Seth goes on to state that Simon appeared as though he were Jesus. Now, this position that it was Simon of Cyrene who was crucified in place of Jesus was a cardinal tenet of that early Christian group known as Basileans, which flourished in Egypt during the early 2nd century, and which claimed to have received its message directly from Glaucus, the translator of Simon Peter, one of the 12 disciples. Additionally, the Acts of John, 97 through 101, reported that the crucifixion of Jesus was an illusion. However, it's not just within these so-called apocryphal writings that one finds evidence that it was not Jesus who was crucified. The biblical Gospel of Matthew, chapter 27, verses 11 through 26, gives us a most important story of Jesus having been arrested and brought before Pontius Pilate for sentencing and trial. And Pontius Pilate, who was the Roman governor of Judea, we're told in the story, really didn't want to condemn Jesus. So he offered the crowd a choice between two prisoners. He said, "Take your choice. I'll release the one that you want